crecer.
Hello, my friends. It's me once again, Manuel DeLaRoacha. This week, I have reviewed the movie The Star Wars. I know, it's a old movie, but Manuel never seen it before. In fact, I had a friend named Herb who came over and let me borrow his VCR because I had an old copy of The Star Wars, you know, but it was on VHS, and I couldn't see it because I don't have a VCR. So Herb let me borrow the VCR. I pulled in the movie The Star Wars and saw it for the very first time. And this is my review of the movie The Star Wars by Jorge Lucas. It came out in 1978, I believe. I don't know. I didn't look at the box too well. It was too exciting to see the actual movie, you know. So we got everybody together, man, and we sat down and we pressed the play on the VCR. And I saw the movie The Star Wars for the very first time. My first impression, man, of the Star Wars is very, very family-oriented. A lot of questions about whose dad is who, who's the son, who's the brother, why did mom and dad have to die in the deserts of Alderaan? I think it was Alderaan. No, it wasn't Alderaan, man. That was a planet that blew up later in the movie. Anyway, I'm moving on. Things I liked about the movie, they had the two robots, right? One is named R2-D2. The other name is C-3PO, I think. He was more annoying, man. The R2-D2, he like had attitude, you know. He was like in his own control, and he was the star of the robots, as far as I'm concerned. Not too many robots in the movie. There's stormtroopers, which aren't like Nazi stormtroopers. They're more like white frogmen looking uniforms. It's hard to explain, man. You have to see it. Yeah, maybe you have already seen it. Anyway, this is my review. I haven't seen the movie, right? So anyway, I see the movie. Lots of good things. We really like the character who went by the name of Han Solo. He's kind of a badass machismo type character, man. Don't care nothing about anyone or even himself. For some reason, he has this sidekick who's like this 8-foot tall Bigfoot who wears this belt. Very interesting. He don't talk much, but somehow he can fly a spaceship, man. Oh, and the spaceships in this movie, man, they are so cool, man. They have the TIE fighters, they have the Y-wings, the Imperial cruisers, man. That's what I want. One day I want an Imperial cruiser, man, so I can control my part of the galaxy and drive around in this super ultra big giant. Oh, you have to see it, man. Things I did not like about the movie The Star Wars would probably be Princess Leia, she's a kind of a bitch, you know. In fact, it's kind of funny, first time we meet her, man, she's in a big thing of garbage. And it's suitable for a princess that has such a mouth on her, man. You know, she's like instantly thinks she's in control, but she don't realize, man, these two guys come down and are helping her get out of the garbage. You know, and that's a philosophical point that I think is underrated in the movie, man. Get yourself out of garbage. You know? Do it. So anyway, I haven't even talked about the bad guy yet, man. The bad guy, his name is Darth Vader. And Darth Vader, imagine all black. He's just not black as in black. He's like color black. He's got this costume and he's got a cape. You know, in the future, I did not know that there will still be capes around, man. That's very interesting. I guess it accentuates the fact that you're kind of bad, but he didn't have a cane, though, or a monocle. He just pretty much walked around with a cape, and he had the, he could, like, choke you with just his hands. His hands don't even have to touch you, man. This is how bad this dude is. And, anyway, Darth Vader, the Imperials and the Rebels, they all have this fight going on. You don't know really why. It's because they don't get along together, okay? So, you take your Darth Vader. He's got some guy that's ahead of him named the Emperor, and they're building this thing called a Death Star, man. And the Death Star, it is freaking creepy, man. It is about the size of a planet or a moon, and it has this laser on it, and it'll blow up your freaking planet, man. So you have to be totally under the control of the Rebel or the Imperial forces, the government. Maybe that is also another thing you take from the movie, man. The Star Wars might subliminally, how do you say that word? Subliminal? You know, undertones of the movie might make you think of other stuff. You know, like maybe your current situation with your own government. Is there a Darth Vader in our Congress? It's very, very interesting to think about, you know. I did not think I would get these messages from this really old movie, the Star Wars, you know, because it came out before Ronald Reagan, man. And that's a mind, you know what it is, it blows with your mind. Anyway, back to the review. I do hope they make a sequel to the Star Wars, because it kind of finished with stuff that could happen. You know, sure, the Rebels win and blow up the Death Star because there's no passwords and the Imperials have this weak point in the planet of the Death Star. Yeah, I could see sequels, man. You could make a couple more. You know, you could deal with other planets. Maybe they build another Death Star. Han Solo, maybe he has space ship problems. I don't know. Overall, I would say I would give this movie out of 5 stars. I would give it how many stars? Really, I want to really give you my real review, you know, so I really got to think about this. 5 stars is, there's not very many movies of 5 stars, man. They don't make movies that are 5 stars anyway, but that's today. Considering this is an older movie, maybe it has more powerful impact. And I would have to say, with all the family issues and the subliminal points, I would have to give this movie 4 stars, man. 4 stars. No problem. We can give it 4 stars. So that is my review this week. The movie, again, is called The Star Wars by Jorge Lucas. And I will be back next week. I'm going to go back to my heritage and my roots and see a more Mexicano kind of film called The Three Amigos. So till next week, my friends.